Are you this church?
Amen.
Now it's our time to listen to the word of God. But before we're going to call you, I'm going to call our guest speaker this morning. I would like to give you some background about him. His name is Pastor Rico Blevens Alu, and he is currently the senior pastor of JCM of all UAE. We have the Abu Dhabi, Al Ain, and Ajman. And by profession, he's an architect. And I would like to inform you, those who are not here, those who are not able to attend our anniversary last 2016, he is also our speaker. Amen. So actually, this is a continuation of his of our mission or the theme that we have before. This is a continuation. Last time, our last anniversary, our theme was Soaring High. So today, our theme will be the continuation. Since you have soared high already, and now we're going to grow wider and reach farther. Now, this will come. Welcome, Pastor Blevens Alu, as our speaker this morning. Let's give God a clap offering for his life. Amen.
And praise the Lord. Can I just ask somebody to put down the banner of your church next to the Philippine flag? Amen. Praise God. Thank you so much. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Isn't it an anniversary right now? Not a death anniversary. Amen. So tell the person on your left, on your right, I'm glad that you are here. Amen. Praise God. Let's give the Lord a clapping hand. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. So today we will study the Word of God, and we have it on our presentation. I hope you can see me from there, although those people that are on the right, I think you'll be having a hard time seeing what is written in the overhead projector, but I like to believe that the Lord will just give us the opportunity today to really study the Word of God. So pulling natin ito. Amen. Praise God. Can we have our presentation ready? Amen. Praise God. Thank you very much for inviting me. It's been an honor for us because last year I was here also with you for the anniversary last year. And then during that time, I think it's a transition point of the church also because last year we have installed your pastors. No? I mean, I'm so honored and privileged by the Lord to be able to install your senior pastor, Pastor Ernie, who is unfortunately is already back in Manila, and of course your associate pastor during the time, Pastor Jules. But I'd like to believe that the Lord has molded and made the church to what it is today, and today we will continue on what God wanted us to have. And as your theme today, or this year, you know, one thing I like about anniversary is that you don't make a theme for the day. Marami po ako, there's so many anniversaries that I have come, and they just say, what is the theme for the year? But actually, they only make a theme for the day. And then they forget what the Lord is asking them to do for the whole year. Brothers and sisters, let me just tell you right now, whatever the Lord is asking you right now, whatever this theme right now is not just good for a trampoline year, it is for you to look forward to what you will do and what God will do in this church.
Amen.
So therefore, you have to stay focused, you have to stay faithful on whatever God is doing to you. Amen. I don't like to go to churches, and in fact, you know, every time I go to a church where there is an anniversary, you know, there's also one church in Sharjah that every anniversary for the last 4 years, I've been their speaker. Not because they want me to speak, but because I am part of that vision. And I like to believe that Pastor Jules, together with your leaders, believe that I'm also part of your vision. So therefore, I would like to ask you today to remain faithful to what the Lord has called you for this year. And that is for you to grow wider and reach further. Let's all stand right now for the reading of the Word of God. Amen. Okay? I can press from light here. Okay? Are we ready? Okay, grow, make it grow wider. Slideshow. What is your slide? Yes, okay. So let me just check if it's going forward. Okay, it's going. Okay, grow wider, reach further, the year of great harvest. And your base text is taken from 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 7. But I don't want us just to leave this text, one, but we will have to take it in the context of the Word of God. Sabay-sabay po tayo. Those that can read, how many of you can read? Raise your hands. Those that cannot read, just open your mouth and follow us. Okay? Are you here? Amen. Amen. Praise God. 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 1 and 10. I don't think you will be able to see from there, but I know you have a photographic memory. You will be just able to open your mouth and follow us. 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 1 and 10. It says here, which let's all read together, the descendants of Judah, Perez, Hezron, Carmi, Hur, and Shubal, Reyes, son of Shubal, was the father of Jahath, and Jahath the father of Halmai and Lahad. These were the clans of the Zorathites. These were the sons of Etam, Jezreel, Ishma, and Idbash. Their sister was named Hazeloponi. Panuel was the father of Jeder, and Ezer the father of Husham. These were the descendants of Har, the firstborn of Ephrathah, and the father of Bethlehem. Asher, the father of Tekoa, had two wives, Hela and Naara. Naara bore him Ahuzam, Hesper, Temeni, and Hahashkar-Tali. These were the descendants of Naara, the sons of Hela, Zeret, Zohar, Ethnim, and Kos, who was the father of Anub and Hazobeba, and the clans of Haharbel, son of Harun. Jabez was more honorable than his brothers. His mother had named him Jabez, saying, I give birth to him in pain. Jabez cried out to God of Israel, and enlarge my territory. Let your hands be with me and keep me from harm so that I will be free from pain. And God granted his request. Let us pray. Father in heaven, Lord, we thank you, God, for the reading of your word today. Lord, we pray right now with the power of your Holy Spirit to be upon us right now, Lord God. The spirit of wisdom, the spirit of understanding, Lord. Father, today we pray, Lord God, as we listen to your word, we will not just be hearers of your words, but doers of your words as well. Father, today we even stretch our prayers to those of people that we love. May they be in the Philippines, or may they be in Africa, may they be in Asia, Lord God, or wherever they are. Father, we pray for your protection to be upon them right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Because we know, as we listen to your word, the enemy will double time, Lord, to disprove all things, Lord God. So we rebuke it right now in the name of Jesus, and we release the spirit of faith and sound mind. Father, we thank you for today, because we will hear your voice upon our vision, and you will let us be people of vision, that we will walk, Lord God, to be able for us to fulfill and to glorify your words. Father, once again, we just want to give you back all the praises, the glory, serve. For this we pray, in Jesus' name, everybody say, amen, amen. Amen. Give the Lord a clap, amen. You can all be seated. We have read the Word of God. It's in 1 Chronicles, chapter 4, and from verse 1 and 10. And your vision is just one of the small verse that is there, that is what we are really looking for. We are talking about territories, but today, before we even talk territories, and so Lord, bring us out there, and you know, we will do the mighty things that you want us to do. I want you to understand one thing, that there are so many prerequisites that God would like you to have and to do for you to be able to
to you to stretch out your territories that God is really asking. Today, I hope and I pray that the Word of God will just illuminate you for you to be understand that whatever your vision is right now, or whatever our church's vision is right now, this is not just about making you feel good. Amen? All the brothers and sisters, now we have more than one nationality. We have this nationality. This is not about nationalities. This is not about colors. This is not about race. This is about Jesus. And if we take of Jesus out of the equation, we will end up with United Nations only. Hello, are you there with me? Hello, are you here? So therefore, today I would like to ask you to be with me and try to open your hearts and your mind. And I hope and I pray that the Lord will continue to open our understanding unto the Word of God. If I'm going to summarize in four words the scripture today that we have read, it will be in these four words: honor, attitude, action, and favor. If I'm going to make a summary of what you're going to be hearing today, it will be summarized into four words: honor, attitude, action, and favor. But let me start first with the word chronicle. That is where we got our vision. First, chronicle. Now, let me start in the word chronicle, so for you to be able to understand. Now, the word chronicle comes from the Hebrew word meaning hayamim. Hayamim, it means a factual, written account, okay, of important historical events in order of their occurrences. This is where we got the word chronological. It means it is a formal or a factual written account of what? Important historical events. But brothers and sisters, the question was, in this books, First and Second Chronicles, we see more names than exploit. Chapter 4, verses 1 to 10, we have read from verses 1 to 8 names. Hello, are you there? Some of you do not even know how to pronounce it. I cannot pronounce some of them. I can only pronounce it Bethlehem. The rest is amen. Hello, are you there? So if you talk about chronicles and we talk about the word as important historical events, how come, Pastor, we are only reading names? Only in verse 8, 9, and 10, we see an account. Why names rather than events? Let me explain this to you. Let me start with this story. There is a man by the name of Irving Bonin. Irving Bonin, he's now dead. He's a philanthropist, businessman. He's a Jew, technically. He was born 1930s or 40s. Not that it is on the same age as me. Maybe some of you are. How many of you were born 1930s yet? Nine, okay. So, Irving Bonin would tell a story about Brit Milah. Brit Milah is when they offer or they ask for the name of the child during the time that he attended. When the rabbi asked the father for the name of the boy, the father responded. So the rabbi asked, "What's the name of your son?" He said, "Abraham, Yishkok, which is Isaac, Yaakov, which is Jacob, David, Shoma, and Yusuf." Wow. So the rabbi asked him, "What is the name of your child?" So he said, "Abraham, Ishak, Yaakov, David, Shalom, Yosef." Wow. Ilan ko sa inyo may mahabang pangalan? How many of you have long names? Wala? Maria, Christina, Belobelida, lahat ng ancestor niya you have taken from all the way back. But this guy gave a long name. So the rabbi was astonished and asked the father, "Why such a string of names? Why so long?" So the father replied, "You know, rabbi, I'm a poor man. So the child won't have much of an inheritance. if he looks like my side of the family, he's not gonna be handsome. Hello, are you there? Okay? If he looks like the side or resemble my wife's side of the family, he would probably not be too smart either. So, I decided to let him at least have a good name. Hello, are you there?
Amen.
Sabi niya, huwag na lang kapangalan ko, not my name. Because if it's on my side, he will not look too handsome. If he get it to my from my wife, he will not be too smart. So I have to give him the names. So it's important for them. It doesn't matter if you're handsome, it doesn't matter if you're smart, but for them, the name is important. Why? Why is it important? Jews always place great emphasis on naming a child. For that, in the name there lay the history, the past of the family, and the hopes and the blessing for a person. Their name is so important, brothers and sisters, that they don't play with it. I don't know about in the Philippines right now, we have funny names. We have Ketket, we have Titit, we have Putput, and we have Matma. Hello, are you there? I don't know about in other countries. Hello, are you there? I even have one, I have a good friend who had a child, and said, Rico, can you be the godparent of my child? I said, what is the name of your child? Magic. But for a Jew, for Hebrew, name is very important. Now, let me explain this to you. In Chronicles, it says events, but if we read, there are no events, only few, but names are there. Why? What's happening here? The name of a person, because a person's name in the Hebrew context summarizes his life, but not his destiny. For them, the name is so important that you don't need to tell them what that person has done. When they tell you, who are you? I am Rico. Brothers and sisters, I don't need to tell you my whole CV. That's how important the name is for Hebrew. That's why in Chronicles, brothers and sisters, they don't need to write who they are and what they've done, what are the exploits. The mere name tells you what they have done and who they are.
Amen.
Your name is important. The name of this church is important.
Amen.
Your personal name is important. That's why take good care of your name. Hello, are you here?
Yes.
Now, when I hear the word, the name Joseph, how many here named Joseph? Raise your hands. If I hear the name Joseph, I don't need to tell you, Joseph is a pastor. Joseph is like this. Joseph is like this. He did this. He did that. No. In the Hebrew context, when they say Joseph, they know already who he is. That's how important the name is. So Chronicles, brothers and sisters, I will explain this to you. Because this is very important for us to understand the vision that you are taking. Your name is very important. UCF. United Christian Fellowship. Am I right? Okay? You know, I have a problem with the word united. Every time you say united, we put UAE next to it. You don't know which one is which one. And I am I'm the former president of UAP, United Architects. So I'm also having problems with the united. But united Christian, it means you have to live in unity.
Amen.
You have to work in unity. So brothers and sisters, a name, a good name is an honor for Hebrew. Ecclesiastes chapter 1 verse 7, it says here, a good name is better than fine perfume. I don't care if you are putting whatever perfume that you have, if your name stinks, you stink. Hello, are you hearing me?
Amen.
I don't care if you're putting the most fragrant perfume, but if your name stinks, you stink, man.
Amen.
A good name is better than a fine perfume, and the day of death better than the day of birth. So what does it mean, brother and sister? I'm going to explain this because it is very important for us to understand the scripture. We'll not just take a scripture and run with it. Let's digest it. You know, how many of you eat here? How many eat? Raise your hand. Nobody eat? Before you go exercising? Sometimes it's better because, you know, you have the strength, but you have to digest your food first. Otherwise, makakaroon ka ng impacto. Are you here with me? Good name is better than fine perfume, and the day of death better than the day of birth. It means it's not how you live your life only, but how you will end your life. Hello? Let's not put our name into such state that we will regret having it. Kilalang ba si Rico? Sino yun? Hello? Si Rico, ano? Eh. Ikaw ba si Rico? Hindi. Siya yun yan. Because the name is very good when it is honored. In Luke chapter 10, verse 20, look at this. However, you know why your name is so important? Let me just explain this to you. However, do not rejoice that the Spirit submit to you, but rejoice that what? Your names are written in heaven. Amen. Now, brother and sister, let me explain this to you. This is my personal belief, my recology. You know what recology is? Not theology, recology, coming from me. I believe that in heaven, there is no big library. There's no such big library. I think they will have just a series of books, and what is written on those books are not what you have done, but your name only. Amen. Because everything that you have done is written under your name. That's why it is in the scripture, the name is used rather than your exploits. Ano yung mga nagawa mo? You know, we have an Emirates ID. Amen. How many here have Emirates ID? Raise your hands. Yung wala, illegal. Illegal kayo. Our Emirates ID is so small, but a lot of what? A lot of information regarding who you are is inside that. And all you can see is a name. Your name. Brothers and sisters in heaven, I'd like to believe that when they open the book, it will not say, Rico, he's a pastor, he's an architect, he's like this, he has done this, he has done that. You know, I will have a volume of that if I don't die early. It will only have a name. Your name. So it's very important for us to understand, to make sure that our name is well prepared on the things that the Lord has done. So what happened now? Look, in Philippians, even Jesus has been mentioned like this. In Philippians chapter 2, verse 8 and 10. And being found in the appearance of man, Jesus, he humbled himself and became what? Obedient to death. Even what? Death on the cross. Therefore, God exalted him to the highest place and what? And gave him the name above all names. God did not say, well, he healed, he did this, he did that. No, just a name above all names. At the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth. The book of Chronicles is not about just an exploit. It's about the name of the person. Are you here?
Amen.
Introduction pa lang po yan. But I want you to digest this. I will not leave you today with you just feeling, oh well, it's a good anniversary. But it is good word of God. So let's start with the first one. First point. Church, let our dreams become our deepest desire. Let our dreams become the deepest desire. This is the first point of our vision for this year. In 1 Chronicles, balik po tayo sa ating scripture, it says there, Jabez. Okay? Jabez was more what? Honorable than his brothers. His mother had named him Jabez, saying, I gave birth to him in vain. I was just explaining to you, the name means a lot. Obviously, Jabez's birth wasn't easy. Hello? Because her mother gave him that name. I don't know about you. How many of you have still mothers alive? Ask them if they enjoy giving birth to you. Mommy, did you enjoy when you were you laughing, smiling, when you know, were you having a good time? Hey, he's coming. No! I'm sure those that are mothers here, you know that it is difficult to give birth. Jabez is extra than that. It was so extraordinary, the pain that his mother has experienced. I don't know why. Maybe for some reason, I was just thinking, maybe he's too big. Now when he came, he's almost like a man.
Hello, Alinder, this is just again my assumption.
But it was so painful that his mother said, "My God, I'll give you the name Jabez. Because you know what? You have made a painful entry into this world." And I like to believe that it is not only in his birth. I believe Jabez's life wasn't easy either. Remember the name? It signifies how the person will be for the meantime. I like to believe that Jabez's life wasn't easy either. I like to believe that his life, because of how, I don't know how he came out, but I like to believe that he is also having painful life as he goes along. I don't know, maybe something's wrong with how he looks, that people are laughing at him. Maybe there's something wrong in how he speaks, that people are, you know, just giving him all the hard time. I like to believe that Jabez, not only that at birth that he gave pain, I believe that Jabez's life wasn't even easy either. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
So yung buhay ni Jabez, hindi madali. Hindi madali. How many here of you right now are having, let's just say, a difficult time in their lives? I'm sure if I ask you to raise your hand, you will raise one, maybe you'll raise two. If you have a third arm, you will probably raise it also. Hello?
Amen.
Tama na akong kausap dito.
Amen.
I'm talking right in English, brothers and sisters. Jabez's life was not just easy. I'm not just talking about the birth, I'm just talking about also his life. The name Jabez means he caused pain. So I can assume that something about his birth was exceptionally more painful than the usual birth. Either physical, either emotional, I don't know. In the Bible times, a name is so important. A name often defines the person's future, what they would become. So perhaps Jabez's mother was also predicting the baby's future. So Jabez's life, I would like to conclude here, until the time that he made this statement before the Lord, is not easy. It's not easy. His mother named him Jabez. Can you imagine your mommy calling you something else? My son is ugly. Hello? Are you there? No, when you came out, is this mine? Yeah, I remember a story of a mother. After she gave birth, automatically they brought the baby to the nursery, you know, in the hospital. So she was excited, I want to see my baby. Because, you know, I just dozed off during the time of the anesthesia, so I just want to see my baby. So she went to the nursery, she was looking at all those babies. So he saw one, ugly one. This is not mine. Hello? Then she moved to another one, said, no, this is not mine. Then she found a cute one. Like, oh, cute, just like me. And then the nurse came and says, "Mom, sorry, your baby is the first one." Hello? Now this is Jabez, brothers and sisters. Why am I saying to you this? Because this is the application for the church. It's not easy. Our lives, even our church, and I know this church, believe me, I'm part of your chat group.
Amen.
Hello?
Amen.
I just don't say hello and hi. But I know what's happening in your church. Our lives, even our church, might not be easy. In fact, sometimes it can be more challenging than ever, especially in the coming end times. Just like Jabez, this life is not easy. I want to say it like this. There will be more uphill climb than an easy down rolling to get to heaven. Where is heaven?
out?
Well, traditionally, we will point up. And there is more effort to go up than to roll down. Amen? Hello? Lalo na yung medyo overweight. You know, you don't only carry the weight of the world, but you're against the gravity. Hello, are you there? So, life can be so difficult, just like Jabez. Church, before you reach to that, say, Lord, give us the territory, God will have to make you prove that you are worthy of the territory that He will give you. By what? By living to the challenges that God has given in your life, not giving up. Hello, are you here? But some of us are already giving up. I don't like this church. They don't have this. They don't have that. We will go to that. Jabez is there. There will be more uphill climb than easy down rolling to get to heaven. We should be prepared and be open to these challenges of life. Church, you will not just have a good anniversary because your 1 year, there will be challenges and maybe trouble. But God wants you to remain steadfast. Are you hearing me? We should press on and continue until the end. See, wala pa ako sa verse 10. But I don't want to give you a false hope that the Lord will increase your territory. He will only increase your territory if you will be able to prove yourself that you can persevere and can hold on to the challenges that God will be giving you. Amen? I hear a lot of churches, Lord, expand your territory. Pagdating ng problema, Lord, I surrender. No way. Jabez is the same. Why did God use Jabez? His pain. God used that. In spite of his pain, Jabez persists on. It will not be easy. Church, it will not be easy. Otherwise, God will not warn us. You know, life will never be easy. How many of you think life is easy? Well, you can think it's easy. You can act like an easy-go-lucky person. But life will never be easy. It is one. Matthew chapter 24, verse 12 to 14. Look at that. Because of the multiplication of wickedness, the love of most will what? Grow cold, but the one who perseveres to the end will be saved. Brothers and sisters, there is a command for us to work out to the point that we will not give up. John chapter 15, verse 20. You know, how do I say this? But I am disillusioned with pastor who only think or who only preach about good stuff. You know, oh, everything will be fine. God is good. If you pray, He will give you this. He will give you that. He will bless you with this. Yes, of course, God will do that. But how can I go against the word of God? In John chapter 15, verse 20, it says there, Jesus said, remember what I told you. A servant is not greater than his master. If they persecuted me, this is Jesus Christ talking. If they persecuted me, they will what? They will bless you. Amen? Amen or no amen? If they persecuted me, they will give you a car. They will give you a house. They will give you an airplane. They will give you a helicopter. If they persecuted me, they will also persecute you. Church, I told this to my wife, I am better off as an architect. Why? Well, I can earn. I've been here for the last 25, 26, 7 years. I've been here for a long time. I'm better off as an architect. I will just attend church. Why not? Give if I want. But why do I need to be a pastor? You know, pastors, it's a problem. Hello? But it's a blessing. It's not easy. Now, brother and sister, that's what the word of God is saying. If they persecute me, they will persecute you. So yung kumakanta na, ang buhay ng Kristiyano ay masayang tunay. Minsan, masayang tunay. Minsan. ang kasayahan ko sa puso lang. Pero kung titignan mo yung external things, there will always be these challenges in our lives. Amen?
Amen.
And I want to teach you to persevere. But when did God promise heaven if life here on earth is already heaven?
Amen.
Then nobody wants to go there. I want to go there. I don't want sickness. I don't want hate. I don't want fighting. I don't want all these nasty things between churches, between pastors. I don't want that. I want to go to heaven. Why? Because heaven is much a better place than what we have here.
Yes.
So persevere. If you're going through life right now, persevere. Just like Jabez, persevere. If you are ugly or painful, go ahead. Hello? If you're having all this miserable time, go ahead. Just continue to move on. Okay? So, the next one. Our action should be our attitude. Hello? So, we only have three, don't worry. This is the second. Even though we don't eat right now, do you mind? Wala yata sumama. Hello? Ah, Pastor, I came here to eat. Well, eat the Word of God. Eat the Word of God. Amen. Not only that you will be having a good life after this, because you eat the Word of God, it will save this church from paying more. Ano? Ano bayaran na ba? Yung pagkain? Okay. Are you here with me? Jabez, sorry for the use of the word, he's a pain in the neck. That's how it is. His life is pain. Now, it is not his doing. Maybe it's something on how he looks, how he thinks, how he says things. But that's what the name is. Therefore, that what is his life in. It must be painful. Ina po sa inyo, kahit anong gawin mo sa buhay, parang it's painful lagi. Lagi ka sawi. Hello? You always try to save money only to end up with no money. Or even negative money. It's pain. But it's not you. But persevere. Number two, our action, what should be our attitude? First Chronicles, let's go back to that. The same scripture. Imagine one scripture to deep words. Now, I move to the first part on the second line, his mother. Now, let's see, in spite of the pain, what is he? Look at him. Jabez was more honorable than his brothers. In spite of pain, in spite of, you know, having a painful life, painful birth or whatnot, the Word of God says he is more honorable than his brothers. In spite of his condition, Jabez excelled above his situation. Hello? Jabez did not let his condition took the best of him, but took his condition to make him the best.
Amen.
Hello, are you there?
Amen.
Why? Look at the word. The word is more honorable. Makapangpangan, more
honorable.
Jabez, in spite of all these things, he said that more honor. Let me just qualify this. I believe among his brothers are not bad brothers. I believe that his brothers were good sons also. And maybe they're also ideal and honest people. Maybe they're also kind and hardworking because the word is honorable. Only Jabez is more than them. Let me explain this to you, church. If you want to expand your territory, this is what it is all about. What made Jabez stand out? The word more honorable. Okay? Why? In Hebrew, the Hebrew context of honor is not being good and being nice. Hello? When you say honorable, it's not about good and nice. The context is, it is first and foremost honoring God in one's life. That's an honorable person in the Hebrew context. It's not that he's good, nice, he's kind. No! For them, an honorable person, first and foremost, what? Put God in the highest place. So, what is the word of God saying? Jabez is not just like a good, kind, you know, person. He is more than his brother because he is the guy who puts God above all things. Hello, are you hearing me? Jabez was honored because of what? His relationship with God. It's not how he sing the praise and worship song. It is not the way he preach. It's not the way he do things. It is the way he worship and adore and revere his living God. Amen. That's what honorable means in that context.
Amen.
It's not being good only. It's not being nice. It's not being kind only. Brother and sister, it is bringing God on top. In fact, in 1 Chronicles chapter 4, Jabez was more honorable than his brother. Look at this. The record of this genealogy, remember the names of the people? All these people were given names of the tribe of Judah. It was interrupted only when they gave the details of Jabez. His relationship with God has been exceptionally noteworthy. Are you hearing me? He's above that. How is your relationship with God, church? Let's put it in context regarding the church. Are you here with me? Are you still here with me?
Amen.
There's a lot of good churches. Amen? There's a lot of good churches. Amen?
Amen.
Why are they good churches? Why? Because a good church has good programs. A good church has a complete ministry. You know, I remember one church, nobody goes there with children because they don't have a children's ministry. Well, a good church, sabi nila, has complete ministry. A good church has touching, worship, singing. A good church has articulate pastors. A good church has a sound financial status. A good church has a comfortable building. A good church has a lot of membership, etc., etc. Yes, that's good. But you want to be more honorable? UCF?
Amen.
Other churches that are here? To be an honorable, more honorable church is the one that put Jesus first. Amen?
Amen.
Even, let me qualify that, even sometimes in the absence or the lack of those above.
Amen.
Never mind if I don't have a building, if I honor Jesus first, I am more. But if that pastor put God first, Jesus first, you have an honorable pastor.
Amen.
Right now, people are just looking for good churches. But God is not, He doesn't like good churches. He's asking for more honorable. Can you say to that person on your left and your right, you can be more honorable? So now you understand what is more honorable? Church UCF?
Amen.
Don't compete with other churches.
Amen.
Don't compete. Bring Jesus. Make Jesus the center of the church.
Amen.
And believe me, and I'm talking also to other churches with all due respect to your pastors, and believe me, then we can go to Chronicles chapter 4 verse 10. Pastor, wala pa tayo sa verse 10? Wala pa tayo sa expansion of territory? No, because God wants you first to endure. I will only expand your territory if you will endure and you will put me first. That's the condition, Pastor Jules. It seems that Jabez, in spite of his hopelessness and dysfunctional beginning, he became a man that always came before God. I know a lot of people move from church to church. They're looking for this, they're looking for that. You know, I don't like your church because you are so solemn. I like this church with dancing, shouting, tumbling, whatever they're doing all these sort of things. I don't want to go to this church. to have, because your church is all in a house, in a villa. I want the one that is in a big mega place. Shame on you. You want to be more honorable? Jesus first.
Amen.
The rest is something. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you. It is summarized here in Colossians chapter 3, verse 10 to 12. And have put on the new self, which is being renewed in the knowledge, in the image of its creator. Here there is no Greek nor Jew, circumcised or uncircumcised, barbarian or Scythian, slave or free, but Christ is all and is in all.
Amen.
Take out Christ in your church, you're nothing.
Amen.
Take out a Christ-centered church, even without music. You know, our church in LA, we're having problems. Whenever we have praise and worship, we are being kicked out of our place. You know, we started with the house. Everybody's, you know, saying, oh, you're too loud, you know. Immigration people come there, police come there, you know. You have your drums, you know. Then we start to move to another place. Again, the same thing, they kick me out, they kick us out. Then we went to hotel, they kick us out. They went to school, they kick us out. They can kick us out everywhere. They can kick out the worship, but they cannot kick out Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. And believe me, we will be probably more honorable than any of those with this kind of things. Number three, our attitude should be our action. Malapit na tayo. Sorry, I mean, church, forgive me. But I will not let you go having a vision of good things that you don't understand. So next year, invite me again. And look at this. Now we are in verse 10. Jabez cried out to God of Israel, oh, that you would bless me and enlarge my territory. Let your hands be with me and keep me from harm so that I will be free from pain. And God that this was a cry of pain. Really? But I thought, Lord, Pastor, he's really looking forward to God. Why? It is a cry of pain. When I say cry of pain, it means a plea of not of disbelief or frustration. He was not crying because he's frustrated. But he was crying because there is a deep desire to even honor God more in his life. Are you hearing me? The cry that Jabez cried out of God of Israel is not a cry of desperation only, but it is a cry of what? Of a deep desire to honor God more.
Amen.
Lord, I want more from you. I want to give you glory more. To honor God in a different kinds of blessing. This is what he said. Oh, that you would bless me and enlarge my territory. I highlighted the word territory. This is what you want to hear.
Amen.
Is it? Do you have to hear? Pastor, we want to enlarge our territory. Let me explain something to you first. The prayer of Jabez reveals that Jabez understands what many people do not. There is only one God, and he should be one, the center of our work. He wants to bless us, and he will bless us. We use the word territory. For those pastors that are here, you know what I'm talking about here. The word territory, okay, we need to understand that it is not just properties. It is influence. Why? In the original version, in the King James Version, the word territory is also used as the word coast. So people say to them, say to the person here, let me write, coast.
Coast.
Atihan mo, coast. We like the word territory because territory sounds wow, you know, even take over the land. But the word is coast. Now the word coast, it means what? A cove, a shelter bay. It comes from the Hebrew word kofe.
There's a big difference here.
Territory going out. A cove is to shelter ships. You want to expand your territory, it's not going there. It's widening like this to people to come in. To have the shelter, to come before the Lord and take refuge within the church. That's what expanding this territory is all about. Amen. Are you hearing me? Yes. This is not about, you know, I tell you, this message to you, church, the territory is not just about more churches planted here and there, putting the name of UCF here, chapter here, you know, association here, members of various races. Oh, this is the territory, we're gaining territory, brothers and sisters. This is not, it's all about. It's about what? It's about drawing men to Jesus in the shelter of His love and salvation. That's what it's all about. I know a lot of churches, yes, they have things really set for. Let's put up a JCM in Ajman. Let's put a JCM in Fujera. Let's conquer UAE. But they cannot even open their arms to shelter the love for brothers. They can even open their arms to give something to the less fortunate within the church. People do not even want it to go to your church. And then you want to expand the territory. Brothers and sisters, the coast that we are talking here is a shelter. And the word of God is simply saying, Jesus is the shelter. It is not your program. Oh yes, you can have a good program. Praise God for that. But it is Jesus in the shelter of His love and salvation. John chapter 12, verse 31 to 33. Now judgment is upon this world. Now the prince of this world will be cast out. Verse 32. And when I am lifted up from the earth, I will draw men to myself. I will be their coast. I will be their cove. I will protect them. I will shelter them. If you will just raise my name, and I will draw men unto me. Church, this is our responsibility. Do not just lift the name of your church. Lift the name of Jesus, and He will draw men. The same word, kofe, to Him. That's His territory. Hello? Pastor, our church, we cannot even go out. I don't care. But if your church is so open with people, you love people, you care for people, you pray for people, you cast out demons on people, you feed people, you are the church of the living God. Yes. Please don't get me wrong, I'm not anti-expansion. Of course, let's take over the world. Wait now. Believe me, we cannot take over the world because the world will hate us. Are you here?
Yes.
Lift Jesus high, and He will be the coast for us. Yusuf, this is my message to you. Lift Jesus high. It's not about planting another here, planting. Yeah, we can always work together with other churches. I love other churches. Hello? You know, I stopped planting churches on the name of our church, but I start planting relationship with other churches. Because we can work together. If Jesus is lifted high, He will draw men to Him. Amen.
Amen.
Almost conclusion. So look at this. Then after only that, after he cried out and said, Lord, bless me and make me open so people can come to you. I can declare you, let your hand be with me and keep me from harm so that I will be free from pain. If the desire of each one of us, especially this church or this church, is to honor God through Jesus Christ alone, then His hands will be upon us.
Amen.
That's as simple as it. Proverbs 16:3 says, commit thy words into the Lord and thy thoughts shall be established. God will be honored. So what's the message? God first, Jesus all.
Amen.
God first, Jesus all. And all things shall be added unto you. Amen. In conclusion, after all these things, what did God say? And God granted His request. Amen. Learn to endure pain. Learn to live the challenges of our Christian life. I'm not just talking about you making utang, you know. How many of you are enduring utang? Debt. You know, you borrow money only for you to endure. That's something else. I'm talking about for Jesus Christ. God granted His request. You want this territory? Brothers and sisters, I'm not even talking about the next door. I'm talking about your door. Amen. Open it for Jesus to be lifted up so that people can come.
Amen.
They'll be attracted to your church. Believe me. They'll be attracted to your lifestyle. They'll be attracted to you. God will never fail us. It is true that He will always grant the desires of our heart. Jabez's name? Yes. It is only His name that is written in heaven, brothers and sisters. Believe me. No details. No chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3. You know, I remember before I interviewed one engineer, one architect in my office. He showed me a CV, 2 pages. I said, well, what details do you have? Then he showed me this kind of book. This is what I have done. I said, any more? Chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3. In heaven, brothers and sisters, Jabez's name is written in heaven. Only the name, no details. Yes, in the Bible, except few words and short phrases. But His life need not have long written narrative because it is acknowledged by God, same as your name. It is all in the Emirates card, as they say. How many of you have Emirates card? Everything is there, right? But what is in the Emirates card? Only your name. That is the same to Him. Jabez endured. Church, you should endure. Jabez preserved amidst the pain of his life. Lifted up the name of God in all times. And have been what? More honored. More honored is not being good, being nice. It is putting God first above all things. Jabez wanted more from God. Lord, it's not enough that I worship You with my life. I want more. I want to bring people to You. From God, not for His honor, but for the greatest glory of God. We ask God for this vision in your church, in your life. Learn from Jabez. Grow wider. Reach further. This might be your year of great harvest. Let's all stand. Let's all stand right now. Father God in heaven, Lord, we thank You, Lord, for being with us today. Your word. Lord, today, God, You just simply told us that sometimes we just take things for granted. Lord, we want this, we want territory, but Lord, You are the God who knows all things. God is saying, persevere. Endure the pain. Endure the hardship. Do not give up. And then honor Me. Not just be good, but honor Me.
Yes.
And then, I will give you that opportunity to open your arms and let Me be lifted up so I will draw men unto Me. That is what it is. And I will hold you. I will protect you. And I will be with you. Father, today I will just ask You to bless this church. Bless every leaders, every members, every partners of this church to be one in lifting Jesus high. Father, we just want to give You back all the praises, the glory and honor that You deserve. For this we pray. In Jesus' name, everybody say, Amen.